Hey everyone, and welcome to the start of another weekly reading vlog. It has been a little while since I've done one of those, but yeah, I was intending to do one last week, but then I got a massive cold and my voice really wasn't working. So yeah, talking wasn't really an option, so the reading vlog didn't really work out, but now I'm feeling much better, so I'm going to try again with this one. But also, I barely read anything last week, so you didn't really miss out on anything. But this week I'm very much intending to get back into the reading flow again. And first of all, I want to do that with a very important reread, and that is of course the reread of Lord of Shadows by Cassandra Clare. It's only 1 week until Queen of Air and Darkness comes out. I think this vlog is going online on the publication date, so excited for that. But I still need to reread Lord of Shadows, so that's going to be my main goal this week. Because, yeah, I just need to reread this because there's so much I have forgotten. It's a big book. I've only read like 30 pages so far. So wish me luck with accomplishing that. But of course, it's a reread, so usually I can get through those a little bit faster than with like books that I read for the first time. So yeah, very excited to be experiencing this story again, and I cannot wait to find out how it's all going to end, and it's going to be amazing. Then I'm also listening to the audiobooks of the Ghosts of the Shadow Market novellas by Cassandra Clare. So this is like a collection of short stories that she has been releasing throughout the year, and I haven't been keeping up with them. I've read the first two stories, but then I decided to just sort of like binge read them on audiobook and just finish all the stories again for Queen of Air and Darkness. And the story I'm currently listening to is The Land I Lost by Cassandra Clare and Sarah Reese Brandon. And after this, I only have one novella story left. So again, want to finish that this week, but I'm pretty sure that's possible because the stories are not too long, and I've already listened to quite a lot of those last week. Like, that was the reading that I did last week, just listening to audiobooks and not much else. So yeah, that is it for reading this week. And apart from that, yeah, it's going to be a pretty average week, but I think a fun one. I have some stuff planned, and also I really want to start decorating my room for Christmas, because this weekend, it's the first weekend of December, and yeah, I want to like experience my Christmas decorations as long as possible, so I really want to start decorating on the 1st of December. And also, I have a lot of school stuff that's also important. I really have to do so much for school, but hopefully everything is going to work out. So that's probably what I should be doing right now. And yeah, I only have the morning today because from 3 till 8 I have to work. So I should probably stop talking and get back to work, because there's a lot to be done. But yeah, hopefully everything will work out. And yeah, I'm very excited for this week. I'm so happy to like feel like myself again, because last week I was just a bit of a mess with battling a cold. But now I'm feeling great again, and that's really nice. Hey, so it is now Tuesday, and this morning I tried to do a sort of fall-like inspired makeup look, and I think it turned out pretty okay. At least I like how it looks, and yeah, I just love like these coppery colors. And for this I used a MAC Cosmetics pigment in the color Copper Sparkle. I know sometimes people ask, so yeah, that's what I used, and I really love the color. But anyway, I'm in a bit of a makeup mood lately. I just love makeup, and I love trying everything out, and especially during fall and winter, it's just so much fun to do eye looks and be all glowy and everything, and yeah, I just love it. But anyway, whilst doing my makeup this morning, I finished the audiobook of The Land I Lost by Cassandra Clare and Sarah Reese Brennan, and it was a really enjoyable story. I think it's the best story of like this collection of stories so far. It's definitely a very cute story that makes you go aww. A lot of fan service, you know, with a lot of beloved characters from The Mortal Instruments, and yeah, I just always enjoy reading about that. I love that this world is so extended, and that you see a lot of things after the series and before the series. And there was also some important information for, I think, the Dark Artifices, or like, yeah, there was some important information in there. Yeah, it was a really good audiobook, so now I only have one story left. I don't know how it's called, I haven't started it yet, but I'm going to do that very soon. But then last night I didn't read a lot of Lord of Shadows, like only 10 pages or so. And I blame that on my Nintendo Switch, because I recently got a Nintendo Switch, And I'm addicted to play Octopath Traveler. It's so much fun and so addictive. And that's what I'm playing at night. And then I forget to read. And yeah, it's not a very good habit, I think. At least it's not very good with my reading habits. And yeah, I really want to sort of read more. But yeah. The Nintendo Switch is also a lot of fun. And today it's another average day. I have to work for school and yeah, do some basic stuff like I do every day. But tonight I'm actually going to babysit my cousin. She's 7 years old, but like babysitting at night is basically just chilling at that house because she's sleeping. So like nothing much. Probably just going to play some more Nintendo Switch or maybe read some. Like I should be reading some whilst I'm there, because yeah, I just really should be getting on with Lord of Shadows. Queen of Air and Darkness is so close. I need to do this reread before it comes out. And I have a very busy week, as you can tell. I definitely have my priorities straight. Lord of Shadows is definitely a lot more important than working for school, apparently. But yeah, time to get back and yeah, maybe go for a little walk. And I don't know, I also have to clean out my room. Yeah, it's just, it's the average day, nothing special. Hey, so I actually read some of Lord of Shadows last night, so yay, proud of myself. And I'm now at page 157, so yeah, I'm making a little dent in it, and hopefully I can continue at this rate and then finish it on time. Also, I'm now alternating between the physical copy and the audiobook, so I can get this done as quickly as possible, because I think I want to finish this one first, and then if I have some time left, I can finish the last Shadow Market story. But I think it's more important that I remember everything from this book when I read Queen of Air and Darkness than that last Shadowhunter Shadow Market story. So yeah, I'm going to prioritize this one, and this is now the only book I'm reading. And with alternating between the physical copy and the audiobook, I should be able to finish it in no time. So yay. And yeah, last night I went babysitting, and also yesterday I did my cousin's makeup. She's 7 years old. So I did a little bit of makeup on her, some lipstick and like glitter, and she absolutely loved it. It's so cute. Like, she was so excited by it. And of course, she doesn't wear makeup in daily life. It's just for fun now. But she was like blown away by it. It was so cute. And today again, school stuff. It's the same old as always. Also, I have to go to the library, like the academical library, to get some books for my thesis that I'm going to loan, because those books you cannot get everywhere. So yeah, I have to take a trip to that. But yeah, the weather is like horrible today. It's so dark and it's probably going to rain. So yeah, let's see how everything is going to go. But hopefully I can also manage to read some more, because I'm really feeling Lord of Shadows right now, and I want my copy of Queen of Air and Darkness so badly. So yeah, another day, and I'm really excited for it. So it is again another day, and yesterday I did went to the library. It's like the Royal Library in The Hague. I often get there quite a lot of my books for like papers and such. And yeah, I did get the books that I needed. I very much needed them, but it's always such a long trip. Or like long, it's like in total I'm away for 2 hours, but that's quite a long trip only to pick up some books. But yeah, it's necessary, I guess. And yeah, it was very rainy and I just chilled in the train, and I did listen to quite a bit of my audiobook, and I read the physical book of Lord of Shadows. I am now reaching the halfway point, and yeah, I just, again, I want to finish it as quickly as possible. And yeah, apart from that, I cannot really tell you any exciting details about the book or whatever. Like, it's a reread, so nothing can surprise me. But I am a bit shocked with myself, with how much I had forgotten. Like, there's so much I just didn't remember. So many details, so many little things that happen. But like, the book is very long and there's so much going on, so many characters. So yeah, it is good that I'm refreshing my memory, because otherwise Queen of Air and Darkness would have been so confusing. And this afternoon I'm actually going to get a facial, and I'm going to get my brows done. That's why I'm without makeup right now, because I'm going to like get pampered this afternoon, like face mask, brows, etc. And yeah, I always love it. Probably half falling asleep in the chair, because I'm so tired today. I don't know why, I'm just a bit more tired this week. And yeah, in the meantime, I'm here at my desk, being surrounded by books in all shapes and sizes. Books behind me. Oh, my camera is going blurry. Books here behind me, books everywhere. My life is basically books at the moment. Books and playing the Nintendo Switch because I'm also still addicted to that. Also, I'm actually thinking about doing a little bit of Christmas shopping tomorrow. Tomorrow afternoon I have to go to therapy, but in the morning I'm free. So I think I might go do some shopping by myself because, yeah, I have some stuff that I need to get. And I also love just going around these stores and maybe see something I want for my Christmas wish list. I mean, I don't need to go like massively shopping because next weekend, not this weekend, but the weekend after that, I'm actually going on a Christmas weekend away with my mother and sister. We're going to Maastricht, which is in the south of the Netherlands. For me, it's not that close. Like, it's, I believe, a 2.5 hour train ride away. I've never been there, but it's supposed to be a really beautiful, amazing city, and they have a very huge Christmas market. So that is going to be fun, but that's something for next week. But yeah, it's just, it's already Christmas all around. I'm so excited about it. And then again, I believe I mentioned it before, but I want to decorate my room for Christmas this weekend. Christmas decorations are my favorite, and I'm always so sad that they can only last for like a month or so. But yeah, I'm just, I'm a bit tired today, but I'm also just in a very good mood. And yeah, I have to go for my facial in about half an hour. And yeah, very much looking forward to that. Hello and good morning. It is now Friday. Yesterday I had like my facial and it was wonderful. And my eyebrows are looking amazing again. I always love that. But yeah, anyway, I've been reading more of Lord of Shadows. I know it's quite a boring reading vlog when it comes to like the different books I'm reading, because it's just one, it's just Lord of Shadows. But I'm now at page, let me see, 361. So yeah, I'm halfway through, I guess. And also it's suddenly getting really sunny. So yeah, excuse the lighting. It's so weird. It's like sunny and clouded all over. And yeah, sorry. But anyway, still enjoying this. Like, again, nothing new. But I had forgotten some of the very funny moments in this book. Like, Shadowhunter books in general are quite funny. Like, there are some moments here that just make you laugh out loud, especially because they very often come out of nowhere. It's just, like, it's very funny. Like, I love the sense of humor of this book. So yeah, I'm hoping for some funny moments from Queen of Air and Darkness as well, but it will also be tragic. And yeah, and now it's getting dark again. I know the lighting is horrible today. And I will be reading more of this weekend, probably. I really want to finish it before this week is over. And yeah, then something else. I don't know if you're interested in that, but yesterday I received some new makeup. So I've mentioned it a couple of times before, but I'm very much into makeup and makeup items. And earlier this week I decided to completely splurge and treat myself, and I bought some items from Charlotte Tilbury, which is a very expensive brand, I know, but I just received my pay and I was like feeling a bit down, and I really wanted to just treat myself for once. I don't do it like with that many expensive items that often, but I got some amazing products and I wanted to show you them real quickly because they're just gorgeous and I'm in love, so absolutely no regrets. So first of all, I got this liquid lipstick in the color Showgirl, and it's what I'm wearing right now. It's a beautiful sort of, well, plum color, I would say, but I love these sorts of colors. I don't do very well with nudes because my lips are quite dark from themselves. But this is just a gorgeous color, and yeah, it's also, it feels so smooth and almost like you're wearing no lipstick at all. Then I also got this Hollywood Flawless Filter, which is basically a primer slash highlighter. And what I've done is that I've mixed it with my foundation, and it sort of makes your foundation even more beautiful, and it just makes your skin look so healthy and glowy. Like, I don't think you can see a lot of difference within this vlog because of course my camera isn't like a very high definition camera, so it won't catch the subtle glowy difference in my skin. But trust me, in real life it just looks so gorgeous. It just looks like you're very healthy, like you have a very good night's sleep and your skin just looks very good. And then I also got the very famous, or like when you're into makeup this is very famous, but I got the Bronze and Glow highlighter duo. I believe it's called the Film Star duo. And again, it's gorgeous. It's such a subtle bronzer highlighter duo. Like, it just gives such a natural look. Again, I don't think you can see the effect very well on camera, but in real life, it's so pretty and so shiny, and I love it. And lastly, I also got a liquid highlighter, which is also very, very pretty. A beautiful sort of natural shine, but yeah, again, love it so much. So yeah, excuse me whilst I've temporarily changed my channel to a beauty channel, But yeah, I just wanted to share it with you because it's so pretty and I loved it so much. And yeah, it is expensive, but to me it's definitely worth it. So in a little while, I think I'm going to go shopping. I'm not going to go massively shopping, but I just want to go to the city and yeah, see if I can find some Christmas presents already. I like to be prepared in time. Yeah, and I'm going, as I said, Christmas shopping next week, but I also want to go by myself. You know, if I want to buy something for my mother or sister, then I can't do it when I'm shopping with them. And yeah, I think I'm also going to go by the Charlotte Tilbury counter now that I'm like so in love with this makeup brand and see if there's anything else that I love that I can ask for Christmas maybe. And in the meantime, in the train, I can listen to my audiobook. So yeah, I think I have a fun day planned. And then after shopping, I believe I said as well, I have to go to therapy. So yeah, nice day out. And yeah, I just really, it's sunny for the first time, as I said, in a really long time. It's been so dark the entire week and now it's sunny. So yeah, a bit of fresh air, a bit of sunshine and a little bit of shopping. It is the 1st of December. I'm so happy. The best month of the year has finally started. And it also means that I can finally open the first door of my chocolate advent calendar. So it's like this celebrations calendar in the form of a Christmas tree. And it has all these kinds of like chocolates, mini Mars, mini Milky Way, whatever. And I love all of those chocolates except bounties. But my mother likes bounties, so she can have those. But I'm going to open the first door and I really hope it isn't a bounty, because that would be a bit of a bummer on the first day. But yeah, let's see what's inside. Okay, it's actually a bounty. That's a bit sad. Okay, that's too bad. This one is going to my mother. I don't like bounties, but hopefully better luck tomorrow. Yep, apart from this, I like all the chocolates in here. So, you know, now I have a bounty out of the way and then hopefully tomorrow I have something better. So I put up the first Christmas decorations and I'm far from done. There's like so much more here in this box and I want to put like lights all over my bookshelves. But like the first few things are a fact, and I'm especially happy with this gorgeous, well, what it's called, like a cutout. This is new. I got this at the Christmas like garden center and it looks gorgeous and it's so pretty and, well, very Christmassy, and I love how it looks like with my shelves. Such a gorgeous addition. And yeah, I'm completely ready for Christmas. I'm so happy that it's finally time. I need to clean out my room as well. And yeah, I think I will continue tomorrow with all the other Christmas stuff. By the way, I also completely forgot to mention that my shopping yesterday was very successful. Basically, I'm done with my Christmas shopping. Like, I have gifts for everyone. So very pleased with that. And of course, I cannot show it to you because it's still a secret. And yeah, I'm so excited. And we don't have a Christmas tree up yet downstairs, but as soon as we have, I'm going to put all the presents beneath it. And yeah, I might wrap them this weekend or maybe next week, I don't know. But yeah, I was very happy that I found fun things. And yeah, hopefully everyone will be very happy with it. And I'm already so excited for Christmas. It's the 1st of December and I'm already like in the best Christmas mood ever. And I think now the rest of the afternoon, I'm not going to do much. Just have a lazy afternoon because, of course, December is so busy. So I think it's important to also get your rest every once in a while. Because even though December is a lot of fun, sometimes I feel like I'm just like going on. Lots of stuff, things to do, things to arrange, school stuff. So sometimes it's nice to be a little bit lazy and just, well, read, I guess, or play Nintendo Switch, or maybe watch the new episode of Crazy Ex-Girlfriend. I still need to do that. And yeah, I'm also still making great progress with Lord of Shadows. I think I might be able to finish it this week. And still, I cannot wait for my delivery of Queen of Air and Darkness, but it won't be this week, unfortunately. But I guess we'll see. And now I'm just going to relax. I'm just tired. I'm lazy. I'm done with today. So for part two of my room Christmas decorations, I now put on my lights around my bookshelves and they are so pretty and I'm so happy that they're back. I love it. And I also have my little like Christmas thingy up here. I don't know what to call it, but that's also back. So yeah, completely ready for Christmas in my room. I have Christmas trees, Christmas lights everywhere, and I couldn't be more happy. So it is now Monday again and we've come to the end of another reading vlog. Exciting news, yesterday I finished my reread of Lord of Shadows. So yeah, really happy about it. Also sad because, of course, this book is so emotional and like, well, pretty much out there. Like, there's a lot of stuff happening in here. And also I finished the last of the short stories of the ghosts of the Shadowhunter market. So I'm completely caught up. I've read everything. that there is to read about Shadowhunters right now. So Queen of Air and Darkness, I'm ready. Cannot wait to receive it. The publication day is tomorrow. Cannot wait. So excited. It's going to be amazing. I just wanted to say real quickly that I don't know how many reading vlogs I'm going to do in December, because December is so incredibly busy. I have so much stuff to do, school stuff, but also fun stuff. And yeah, I want to like do reading vlogs, but only if it works out for me. If I'm too busy and I cannot edit everything or I cannot film everything, then that's just the way it's going to be. So I'm not going to quit reading vlogs, but they might be a bit more sporadically, I guess. And then in the new year, I will definitely be back with like doing weekly vlogs. But now, like, it's just going to be there when it's going to be there. Maybe I will do like a vlog of 2 weeks if that's easier. I'm definitely not going to vlog like the week during Christmas, because that's just family time. I'm not going to vlog that. Also, of course, the end of the year videos are coming. Favorite books of 2018, worst books of 2018, all that sort of stuff. So that's also going to take a bit of time. And I'm also like always so excited about those videos. So don't worry, there's going to be like videos in any case. But I am busy in December, so it might be a little bit less. Like it might be only one video per week instead of the usual two. I'm just doing whatever works best for me, so just so you know. But this was it now for this video. If you like this video, please go subscribe or maybe give it a thumbs up, because I would really appreciate that. And hopefully I will see you again very soon in my next video. Bye!